Hi boys and girls, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play. I'm trying to mess about with my microphone to make sure you can hear me as best as possible. It's down there, which means it's on my lap, which means sometimes it tends to get a little bit mushy because I'm moving about. Sorry about that. Doing my best to deal with it. Problem is, I'm sitting on the couch. There's not really room for a big microphone setup. We could get one of those little headsets, but I don't want to look like a divvy. I wouldn't be comfortable. All the wires. I've got enough wires going on with this thing. So I thought I'd do another one from my Games What I Have Made playlist. I use the term very loosely on this one. The guys who really did the work on this, I feel like I shouldn't be little work on it. Basically, when I arrived at Virtucraft in late 2001, this game was pretty much finished. And in my training, if you like, I was asked to do a lot of testing on games that were coming out, or well, were coming through, and were nearly ready to go out. And this was one of them. I only gave it a few days, to be honest. I was lucky, to be honest, that I got this and not Mortal Kombat Game Boy Advance. Anyone who's played Mortal Kombat Game Boy Advance knows what I'm talking about. I won't apologise because I wasn't involved with that. It was happening in the background of all this stuff. I do apologise. I'm trying to turn the volume down here on my microphone so it doesn't come through my microphone. and you'll get the proper sound from the device. While they were making possibly the worst version of Mortal Kombat that is out there, if you want to see a really bad Mortal Kombat, go and check that out. I was testing this. Only testing. No art. You know what? I did so little on this, it barely justifies going on here. But I did spend a couple of days cutting my teeth and testing. And to be honest, testing all these games got me pretty decent at testing. Not great. I know testers who are great. But decent. I can hold my own testing a product. Even today. Those of you who know, I've made my own games. I did all the testing myself, and they went out bug free, which was great. I don't think I had to do any updates. Now, my input on this was so little that all I remember about it is it's isometric. So I'm rediscovering how to play. In fact, I think all I did was try and break it, going through landscape and whatnot, and hammering buttons and spamming things and making sure that everything was solid. Let's actually play the game. It's something I never did back then. So Dexter's Laboratory, Deesaster Strikes. I remember being quite impressed with it, the way it looked, and the way it played. I mean, it feels like a cartoon. It's got the same sort of colour schemes, everything feels right. Maybe it's a little bit exact and quantized, because I think the Dexter's cartoon had a kind of irreverence to it, didn't it? Like a lot of Cartoon Network cartoons. Things like this computer, for example, look very nice pieces of pixel art. That said, we've got this kind of faux perspective to some of those side computers there, that you don't normally get in tile map games. So we were trying to do that, capture that Cartoon Network randomness, you know. You see the way these walls are kind of broken down, that everything's kind of soft and bent and wobbly. The lines on that computer monitor on the edges are all wobbly, and we were trying to get that. We weren't trying to make it. If you look at the floor on this, for example, those tiles are just very, very dull, very set. And when the screen's folding, that doesn't really look right. But a lot of the background elements like this look great. And they feel like the cartoon, and we were trying to do that. There's one Cartoon Network license I worked on very heavily as my first proper full-on game at Virtucraft, and we'll get to that. I'm very proud of it. I could do a much better job of it today, of course. But that opportunity won't come. Which is a shame, because it would be great to see it. But we'll come to that. This is one I tested. Basically, Virtucraft had... Ooh, hello, you look vicious. Virtucraft had all the... Let's see if we can attack. Don't seem to have any kind of... There's DD. DD. I don't think... Oh, no, she's following me. Ow, that was not the place to stand. Okay, she's coming with, I think. Unless you get stunned and she doesn't. I think what you've got to do is lead, if I remember rightly. And I don't remember anything about the way this played. You've got to lead the little DDs, maybe even catch them. Let's see. No, all I can do is jump at the moment. And she's not coming with me, so maybe I need some cheese or something. Oh no, that was actually a four. Mike, you're an idiot. As I say, I don't remember much about this game. I spent a few days with it, just making sure that the essentials didn't break. There wasn't really much more time to spend with it, because as you'll see, I was busy with a lot of other games. Just testing, just getting to know how the studio worked. Come on, Dee Dee. Go this way. No, she's back over there dancing. Come on, Dee Dee. Yeah. Oh, shoulder buttons. Hello, shoulder buttons. Die, robot, die. Yes. With that, that's got to be useful. I can't remember any of this, you know. Actually, can't. Oh, hello. I just picked you up. Let's use. No. Use. You've got to be a. Aha. Dee Dee's collected. Yes, you've got to collect the Dee Dee. This is much more complex than I remember being. I remember just running around. I don't think I ran around much. As I say, out of all the games that I worked on, this is probably the one I worked on the least. Ah, there we go. Okay, that worked. Can I rescue Dee Dee now? Collect. Rescue. I wonder if I can jump up and hit. No, I don't think so. Okay, I can't remember any of the objectives or any of the mechanics. Let's leave that. Oh no! Let's leave that Dee Dee bit. Hang on, I'll run way back again. Yeah, I remember being very impressed by this. But when I was working on this, I was also working on several other games testing. Well, I was going to tell you what they were, but I think I'll leave that for the next video, so you can actually see what they were. And of course, if you're watching this like a few years down the line, you'll know what they were because they'll already be there. I do apologise for not putting any of the games what I have made set up for a while. I think the combination of Dexter's Laboratory not really being one I worked heavily on, and a combination of just wanting to play some games and have a bit of fun with the NES has led me to not do very many. It's a solid game, this. Like some of the games we've played on the NES are a bit kind of sparse in terms of content and gameplay, and I suppose they will be the 8-bit games. We should expect better with the GBA. And this does deliver, I think. I think it's a great game. For what I played of it, as I say, I did play it a bit back in the day. I'm probably doing myself a disservice there. I did get into it a little bit. I don't know what to do with you. I'm not sure we've got anything with you. Can we move you over there? Maybe get the laser to shoot you? No, let's just leave that alone. Hello. So we need a spanner. Have we got a spanner? Have we got a spanner? No. We haven't. What was that? Remember that being of use. Yes. Ah, look, it's all opened up. This game's great. And if I wasn't involved in this and I'd just come across it, I would be very impressed by it. That is the menu. The isometric is a little bit tricky. It has to be said. Oh, she's able to grab that. I really thought that looked perfect for grabbing a barrel. Maybe it's for grabbing DVDs. Come here. Yes, it is for grabbing DVDs. Right, you. How cute is that? I can't even remember these animations or anything. As I say, I played it for a couple of days, possibly even, well, no, it was a couple of days. While, oh my god, so where does this Dee Dee go? We've got to find the place that Dee Dee's go now. Oh no, see, that was a bit, wasn't happy with that. There's a bit of that, the isometric sometimes breaks. That is probably, to be fair, an emulator issue. Don't punch Dee Dee. Pick up Dee Dee. Up, Dee Dee, and there we go. I'm using one button. It's because we're using an Xbox pad. I've got the option of four buttons, and I am using them all. I should just be using the two. Where do Dee Dee's go? That I haven't figured out, or it hasn't made itself apparent to me yet. It's been a very long time. 2001, as I say. Let's just have a little wander and see what else is going on. We know how to pick up Dee Dee's now, so that's good. Oh, hello. Yeah, I wonder if we pick up robots. Button. Oh, I see. Oh, okay. It's like that, is it? Bit of logic. Yeah, it's a very good game. I mean, there are a lot of good games on the Game Boy Advance. And Basecraft got in there, you know, he really got in there. As I say, we got a lot of Cartoon Network licenses. The company already had a load of Cartoon Network licenses before I started working for them. That's got to be where the DVDs go, isn't it? Or maybe not. It's just a teleporter. Maybe the DVDs go in here. Let's go and grab that DVD over there. If I remember rightly, there is one. And let's put it in the DVD compressor. I said DVD too many times. Oh, what's he got? I'm sure there's one here. Hang on. Is that a DVD? Excuse me. Hand type of hand. That's the one. Is that a little thing called? Because it's a DVD right next to me. Apparently not. But yeah, they got loads of Cartoon Network licenses. I think they were basically working with BAM, who were working with Cartoon Network. And Betchercraft did very well off those licenses. They started off with Game Boy Color stuff. There's a lot to see in this game. I mean, I'm going to scratch the surface right now, but I do definitely recommend if you guys like it, look at this, give it a go. It's a great game. I played it for a bit, I tested it, I made sure that things weren't irreparably broken, and to be fair, nothing was. So that was me hitting the speed button on the emulator. That wasn't a feature of the game. I just hit the wrong button on the pad. And that's the one. I definitely recommend you give this a go. It's very good. It's better than I remember it being, to be honest. I mean, it's hard because there's a lot kind of thrown at you straight away in terms of what you've got to do. Where's she just gone? Okay, I see something reset itself there. So there's got to be a place to put the DVDs here. I'm sure in the instructions it makes more sense. I haven't really read any of it. If anything, it's only fault really is that it's a bit complex from the word go. Some of the other games I worked on it went, so. I'm going to leave that here. But what I will say is, while I was testing this, it was about training. So I was testing a load of games, cutting the teeth. And this was one of them. We'll come across the other games I was testing in that kind of first month with Virtucraft to me, all of which were pretty close to completion. And I was brought in for the next batch of games, and I hit the ground running once I started doing actual proper art for my project, which lasted 9 months, believe it or not. So I was one of the two main artists on the Cartoon Network project. And yeah, it took 9 months, and there was a lot of work, a lot of deadlines, a lot of milestones, a lot of attention, a lot of cutting my teeth and panicking and worrying, and a very, very good lead artist, which I'll come to. But before I did that big project for Vegicraft, I did a lot of these little ones just testing the likes of this and the next batch of games that are coming up. So enjoy. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back with more. Bye for now.